Those are the new stances and moves in this new form. Back stance and outside block. Kicho Yi Bu Hyung, the second in the Kicho series of beginner forms for white belt. Let's learn the form.
자, 경례. 준비. 시작.
You'll notice that the form goes in a capital I shape, just like the first form. Kicho Ilbu, Kicho Yibu, and Kicho Sambu, all three, there's three in the Kicho series, they all three go in a capital I shape. That's how you can remember. The new stance is back stance, which looks like this. Back stance is a sturdy stance. It's a diagonally sideways stance. You're not sideways like this. So if I'm facing you, I'm not like this. Like my body is not facing this way. It's actually comfortably facing you with the front leg bent and the back leg bent. But the catch is you have 70% of your weight on the back leg, 30% on the front leg. Exactly like that. L shape. You can do it comfortably to where you're relaxed in the stance. So your feet will naturally be a little bit in. Not exactly a perfect straight L like this. Perfect. You have it more relaxed where this foot is going to be inward a little bit. So inward a little bit. And then this foot is going to be tilted towards this way, that way. So if you switch your feet, the front foot is going to be diagonally that way. Not perfectly straight, but diagonally that way. The back foot is relaxed, kind of off to a diagonal angle. It does not have to be perfect L shape. Perfect L shape would look like this. It's too blocky. It's not natural. You don't have a good balance. If you relax into the stance, you have better balance. To understand if you have 70% and 30% weight divided between your feet, you need 70% on the back leg, 30% on the front. You can try to do a front kick, just and without moving too much. If your body has to move back to kick, that means you're not in the correct stance. You have too much weight coming forward, like this. Now, if it's too much weight going back, you look like your butt is hanging off to the side, and it's not natural, it's not a good balance, it's too difficult. It doesn't make any sense to do that. This is a natural stance to turn off to the side like this. You can tell 70% and 30% when you do your front kick, and you only move like that much, like maybe an inch. So if you do this, okay, if you could hit a front kick about chest level and barely move, you're doing okay. Now if you're all the way back, you'll feel that you're off balance and you're gonna fall backwards. And if you're frontward and you have to do a front kick like that, it's wrong. Now let's practice the form. Kicho Yi Bu Hyung, the second Kicho form. The first move is back stance outside block, going left. So back stance is called deep kubi. Deep kubi. Think of it as think of it as D-W-I-N-T, dweet, like saying dweet, but say it fast, like dweet, dweet, almost like a V and a W at the same time, dweet, dweet, kubi. So dweet, kubi, outside block, okay? First move. Second move, step forward into long front stance punch to the solar plexus level of kubi. Jiragi is punch. Go left. Same thing on the other side. Now we go down the middle. Do a down block in the long front stance. Now do three punches in long front stances and then key up out of the last punch. One, two, three, and key up. Next move, go that to that crazy spin move we learned in the last form, in the last video. The turning to the left backwards. Back stance, outside block. Step forward and long front stance, punch. Back stance, outside block. Step forward, long front stance, punch. Now go down, back to the left, down block, long front stance. Three punches and key up. Now finish, just like the very beginning. Do the same thing you did at the start on this side. Outside block, punch. Outside block, back stance, and punch. So that's the whole form. Let's do it one more time. When you do the outside block and you do the punch, keep the outside block, keep the same shape. Keep it there. Step forward, punch, pull it to your hip. A lot of people develop the habit to do this, straighten it out, and then punch. Don't do that. Do it this way. This is wrong. Don't straighten first. Okay, that just slows it down, makes it look a little awkward. So to the hip. To the hip. Key point on the outside block. Keep the block shoulder level. So imagine there's a line to the shoulder to the top of the knuckles. Not high, not low, but just equal. When you're doing the block, it's not going to be sideways. It's going to be sort of in front, like this. Not completely out, but straight up and down almost, but a little off. Not perfectly straight, not, but, okay, right here. You should be able to see over your fist. If you can't see over your fist, you're doing it wrong. So. When you do the block, think of it as twisting, like almost like you're gonna do a back fist, but you twist at the last moment, you turn out, so you're blocking, like boom. So it's twisted this way really tight and then twist out. So that twist. That's how you do it. And that's how you do the form. By this time, you need to learn not to bounce up and down when you're doing your forms. If you're doing long front stances, do not raise up and down. This is incorrect. You want a smooth, straight motion. So when you're bent down in that stance, you stay low and keep going forward. Punch, that kind of thing. Another thing, putting your hands by your belt is a good guidance for beginners, but really the waist area, anywhere around here, is where you can put your fists relaxed. They don't have to be sturdy down here. Maybe they're too low. Maybe your belt's too low and it feels weird. It's more natural about a little above the belt for me. Other people are different. Depending where you tie your belt, just know that your hand goes by your waist. We teach beginners to put their hand on their belt, but over time, they should be able to relax into it and have it by their waist like this. It doesn't have to be on the belt, but just don't bring it too high. Another thing, your fists can be right here, sort of inward. They don't have to be exactly sideways. It's not natural. This is weird, and it's not relaxed. This kind of sitting in front is more relaxed, so you can do it like that. Now that you've learned how to do Kicho Yi Bu Hyung, which is the second Kicho form, the second basic form for white belts, you need to practice it. So go ahead and practice it, rewind the video and watch it a few times, and practice, and you'll get it down. This is very good for developing strong stances and strong muscles and basic punches and the outside block. Right on your haka seyo.